In our last lecture, we studied about salt hydrolysis and buffer solutions. And in today's class, we are going to learn about solubility product. This term starts with solubility. So first of all, we define this. What is solubility? Solubility is a temperature dependent term. So we always mention at constant temperature or fixed temperature. It is defined as amount that is generally taken in moles, although it can be given in grams per liter as well, but we generally take it in moles. So amount of solute dissolved per liter volume of solution, per liter volume of solution. This is defined as solubility. As I told you, its units can be grams per liter or its units can be moles per liter. In either of the two, we can depict the term solubility. But when we define this solubility product, first of all, it should be very clear that this is applicable for sparingly or partially soluble salts only. Sparingly or partially soluble salts only. What it means? It means that when we define the solubility, then this is not simply a term. It involves two types of energetics in the dissolution of a salt, and two types of enthalpies are involved during the solubility. The first one is called lattice enthalpy. Lattice enthalpy. This is depicted with the symbol delta H naught lattice. And the second one is the hydration or solvation enthalpy. Hydration or solvation enthalpy. We write it as delta H naught hydration or delta H naught solvation. This is under standardized conditions. So what is lattice enthalpy? As we say, ki salts are ionic lattices, three-dimensional lattices of ions. So the amount of heat required to break one mole of ionic lattice and to make its respective ions free is defined as its lattice enthalpy. Let's repeat. Ek baar fir se dekhte hain कि वन मोल लैटिस आपको दिया जाए, सो कितनी हीट मैं उसे प्रोवाइड करूं जिससे वो सारे आयंस के बॉन्ड्स को तोड़ के आयंस को फ्री कर दे और इस तरह वो लैटिस ब्रेक हो जाए. एंड दिस इज अगेन गिवन इन पर मोल. दिस वैल्यू इज एक्चुअली एंडोथर्मिक. दिस प्रोसेस इज एंडोथर्मिक. दैट्स व्हाई डेल्टा एच लैटिस एंथैल्पी शैल बी डिपिक्टेड विद द पॉजिटिव साइन. नाउ वंस द आयंस आर फ्री and they are dissolved into solvent. एक बार आयंस फ्री हो गए, सॉल्वेंट के साथ इंटरेक्ट करेंगे, तो वहां आयन और सॉल्वेंट का जो इंटरेक्शन होगा, that is bound to be associated with the release of energy. And this amount of energy released by the interaction between the ions created by one mole of solute and the molecules of solvent is defined as standard enthalpy of hydration, or in common terms, if some other solvent is being used instead of water, we can call it delta H of solvation. So let's see an example. Let I have got sodium chloride and this is a lattice. I have taken one mole. You provided some heat and this heat is equal to the enthalpy of lattice, lattice enthalpy. So that n number of sodium ions and n number of chloride ions can be freed, and let this is, if n is 1 mole, then certainly you will respectively obtain the number of sodium and chloride ions. This is lattice enthalpy. Now once the sodium and chloride ions are free and you are dissolving them in water, what kind of interaction takes place? Like this is the sodium ion and water is a polar solvent as we all know. This has got a negative pole and it is a positive pole. So this positive charge of ion and negative charge of oxygen as a negative pole. They two are interacting together, and this is called ion dipole interaction between the cation and the solvent. Similarly, more water molecules will organize themselves surrounding the sodium ion, and in this way this whole process is associated with the loss of heat or energy. You can have more water molecules surrounding this also, like we could have shown it here again, and this is called solvation of cation. Similarly, anion can also get solvated, like this is the chloride ion and a water molecule. It is present here and its positive pole interacts with the negative charge of chloride ion. Similarly, we could arrange more water molecules like this, and in surroundings this kind of interaction is again associated with loss of energy. So this, I hope you understood, ki what is hydration enthalpy of or solvation enthalpy means solvent and solute interaction, ion dipole interaction is associated with the release of energy, and this energy released per mole of the solute is defined as enthalpy of solvation or hydration. So one process is endothermic and the second process, this one, is exothermic, because this is releasing heat. Now there can be three conditions which are applicable on comparing these two values together. Let me see them one by one. What can happen? There are three possibilities. First one, if lattice enthalpy, that is delta H lattice, if lattice enthalpy is much lesser than delta H hydration enthalpy, we say salt is highly soluble. Salt ki solubility bahut zyada hai, because jo हाइड्रेशन एंथैल्पी है वो लैटिस एंथैल्पी को न सिर्फ ओवरकम करेगी बल्कि इट विल बी इन एक्स्ट्रा अमाउंट. सो द नेट प्रोसेस इज गोइंग टू बी एक्सोथर्मिक. सॉल्ट इज हाईली सॉल्युबल एंड प्रोसेस ऑफ डिसोल्यूशन इज एक्सोथर्मिक एज वेल. इसमें हीट रिलीज भी हो रही है, सो इट इज एक्सोथर्मिक एज वेल. सेकेंड पॉसिबिलिटी, इफ बोथ द एंथैल्पीज are almost comparable, means the values don't differ much, but we say that salt is moderately soluble. Wo acha khasa dissolve ho jayega, so moderately soluble. This is the second state. But here comes the third one, when we say that lattice is very strong to be broken, means the lattice enthalpy is extremely high in comparison to hydration enthalpy. So the third case it becomes, if delta H naught lattice is very high in comparison to hydration enthalpy. Here we say that salt is sparingly soluble or it is partially soluble. Why? Because hydration enthalpy is quite insufficient to break the whole lattice of the salt. That's why it will break the lattice partially and the salt will dissolve partially. So the third case it becomes, here salt is partially or sparingly soluble. And I think now you can connect. Now you can connect that this is the case where we need to study solubility product. So this property which we are going to study, this is shown with a symbol, it is KSP. This SP depicts the solubility product. So I hope this third point you will keep it in mind, ki here only we can apply the concept of KSP. Now we will study in detail, in thorough. Like first, let you consider that there is a AB type of salt, AB type of sparingly soluble salt. AB means there is one cation and one anion. Like we consider, this is the case of AgCl, it can be AgBr, it can be barium sulfide, it can be PbS, any kind of these kind of salts. So I start with this AB solid, try to dissolve it in the water, So this kind of equilibrium establishes. Although this is partially soluble, so what is the state of equilibrium? We say undissolved salt is in equilibrium with the dissolved salt. Means जैसे ही salt आप water में डालेंगे कुछ salt dissolve हो जाएगा और बाकी का salt नीचे जाके settle हो जाएगा at the bottom of container and there will strike a state of equilibrium. आप उसमें ये कह सकते हैं कि here undissolved salt is actually unionized salt. क्योंकि जो आयोनाइज हो पाएगा वही तो डिसॉल्व होगा, वही सॉल्वेंट के साथ इंटरेक्ट करेगा एंड दिस इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम विद द आयोनाइज्ड सॉल्ट. सो द स्टेट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम इज सेइंग दैट रेट ऑफ डिसोल्यूशन बिकम्स इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन. मींस जिस स्पीड पे सॉल्ट डिसॉल्व हो रहा है उसी स्पीड पे सॉल्ट रिक्रिस्टलाइज हो रहा है एंड दिस इज अगेन अ डायनामिक इक्विलिब्रियम. नाउ अगेन वी मेंशन दिस कि लेट एट दिस स्टेट सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ सॉल्ट इज डिपिक्टेड विद सिंबल एस. लेट इट बी इन मोल्स पर लीटर. सो सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ ए इज एस मोल्स पर लीटर एंड सेम इज विद बी. सो we define this term ksp. ksp is the solubility product of this sparingly soluble salt. It has to be the active mass of a into active mass of b divided by active mass of ab. This is solubility s multiplied s divided by 1, because for the pure solid or the pure substance we consider its active mass is 1. So the formula comes to be that Ksp is equal to S square. And if we need to calculate the solubility, it has to be square root of Ksp. On the same lines, when we discuss this concept of solubility product for other kind of sparingly soluble salt, so let me see quickly a few more examples, more types at which we can apply this concept. Let it be now second kind of salt. It is Ab2 type of salt. Ab2 is having cations to anion ratio 1:2. For example, we can consider PbCl2. So Ab2 ionizes in water, dissolves to get A plus twice of B ions. Again, I am talking about their solubility in solution. This is S and 2S. So, Ksp shall be equal to the active mass of A, in that is S, and active mass of B, it is 2S to the power 2. This power 2 is coming through the stoichiometric coefficient. So, coefficient is converted in the power as we studied in the chapter of chemical equilibrium. Like coefficients have to be converted into their respective powers. So, this will become equal to 4S cube. Similarly, we can say that value of S can be calculated as third root of Ksp by 4. This is how we can calculate its solubility. Let me consider the third type of salt. It is Ab3 type of sparingly soluble salt. Ab3 can be like ferric hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide, etc. Few examples I am quoting for you. So Ab3 ionizes or dissolving to give the A plus ions and 3B negative ions. Their respective solubilities are shown with the symbols S and 3S. So, I can say that Ksp is a product of S into 3S cube because its coefficient is 3 here. So, this should be 27S to the power 4 and proportionately S has to be 4th root of Ksp divided by 27. Quite easy to understand, like this is only the types changing, so proportionately the formula will also change, and that you can derive yourself for the other kinds of salts. Just try them yourself. Like if I have got Ab4 type of salt, then what should be their relation? Similarly, you can try it for, let the salt is A2B3 type, then what can be their relations? That is for you to do, and you can very easily now derive them. Now, let's discuss a case with few examples. There are certain specific cases which we can study in this chapter of solubility product. Like, first I'm taking a question, very simple. Let KSP, that is solubility product for silver chloride AgCl, is 2 × 10⁻¹. This is not the exact value, I'm just letting it for your understanding. So let KSP for AgCl is 2 × 10⁻¹. Calculate solubility of salt AgCl in pure water. It means I am dissolving it in water only. So calculate its solubility in the pure water. So understand what is simple to be done. Like AgCl is AB type of salt, as we have just derived, AB type of salt. Now, can I say that its KSP has to be S square, and therefore solubility is under root of KSP. So very simply we calculated that its value shall be √2 × 10⁻¹. Place the value 1.414 × 10⁻⁵ moles per liter. This is at the given temperature, and that is how we calculate its solubility in the pure solvent, pure water. But sometimes in the solvent, some more salt is being added, and that creates a common ion effect. Means the salt and the other salt being added has something in common. Then that common ion, according to Li-Chatelier principle, is certainly going to affect the solubility of weakly soluble salt or sparingly soluble salt. And this solubility will be adversely affected. So now let's visualize the effect of common ion on the solubility of a sparingly soluble salt. And this I will explain you with the help of some example only. So very specifically, we are explaining effect of common ion on solubility of sparingly soluble salt. Sparingly soluble salt. Let me consider an example, and I will solve this explaining the concept as well. Question states, calculate molar solubility. Calculate molar solubility of PbI2, lead iodide, in 0.01 molar lead nitrate. One thing is given, that is given KSP for PbI2 is 1.4 × 10⁻¹. 1.4 × 10⁻¹. Now let me see, how shall we proceed? That first of all, PbI2 is a sparingly soluble salt, so that gives you lead ions plus twice of iodide. Lead, its solubility is S, and this is going to be 2S. But we have added lead nitrate to the same solution, and lead nitrate is a strong electrolyte which is creating a common ion, and that common ion is lead, which is present in PbI2, which is present in lead nitrate. So simultaneously we are ionizing lead nitrate completely. That gives lead ion plus twice of nitrate ion. If the molar concentration of lead nitrate is 0.01, then while after ionizing, this will create 0.01 molar, and this will be 0.01 × 2, that is 0.02 molar. Now, this lead ion, becomes common. At the lead nitrate, it has no impact because this is a strong electrolyte. But the only difference it makes to the dissolution or solubility of lead iodide, because that is sparingly soluble. In such a case, this 0.01 molar will add to the final concentration of lead ion. So this I am going to change here, that from 0.01 plus S, you are actually converting it from S to 0.01S. As we calculated, if the value of S is supposed to be calculated with this value, Ksp of PbI2, so this will be quite less. So shall I say that this S value can be neglected as in comparison to 0.01, because this is quite a bigger value. When lead ion becomes common, this equilibrium, the upper equilibrium, shifts towards left hand side, and in order to consume that extra concentration, this equilibrium is shifted to backward side. Means the solubility of salt will further decrease. So what we should consider, that lead ion concentration, in spite of taking 0.01 plus S, we will take it is nearly equal to 0.01, because we are neglecting here the concept of S. Now let's apply this. Ksp is equal to lead ions concentration multiplied with iodide ion concentration to the power 2. So Ksp is 1.4 into 10 raised to power minus 8. Lead is taken 0.01 into, this is going to be 2s square, that is 4s square. So on after the solving, you can simply solve this question and get the solubility. The value of solubility is 5.9 into 10 raised to power minus 4 in moles per liter. This is what we learned, that when some ion is taken common, then how shall we go with the solubility calculation? Let's repeat it once more, because there is a new concept we have added. If in a solution of sparingly soluble salt, if we are adding a strong electrolyte having one ion common, here as there is lead ion common, how this presence of common ion affect the solubility of sparingly soluble salt. So what we have seen, that if we study this, this lead ion becomes common to both the salts, this lead ion is here, this lead ion is here, this concentration of lead ion will add to this concentration, and this will shift the equilibrium to backward direction or the left hand side in order to consume that extra concentration of lead ion, and its concentration or solubility will further decrease. So you need to calculate in the same way as we generally do, but the only thing has to be taken into consideration, that the concentration of lead ions shall be taken nearly equal to 0.01, because here S is considered to be quite less than 0.01, and do neglect it in comparison to this. Now let's move on. Ab ek aur naya concept samajhte hain, jo ye kehta hai ki साइमल्टेनियस सॉल्युबिलिटी क्या होता है. सो द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज साइमल्टेनियस सॉल्युबिलिटी. दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज एप्लीकेबल व्हेन वी से दैट वी हैव एडेड टू स्पेरिंगली सॉल्युबल सॉल्ट्स इन द सेम सॉल्यूशन एंड दे बोथ मस्ट हैव एटलीस्ट एन आयन कॉमन. एक बार फिर से सुनिए मैं क्या कहना चाहती हूं. सपोज मैंने कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट एंड लेड कार्बोनेट दोनों को कुछ क्वांटिटी एक ही सॉल्यूशन में ऐड कर दी. नाउ बोथ आर स्पेरिंगली सॉल्युबल, बोथ हैव गॉट देयर रिस्पेक्टिव केएसपी वैल्यूज, एंड बोथ हैव गॉट कार्बोनेट आयन इन कॉमन. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट विल प्रोवाइड कार्बोनेट आयन, बेरियम कार्बोनेट इन द सेम सॉल्यूशन will also provide the carbonate ion, and this carbonate ion becomes common to both of them. The addition of these two concentration will affect the solubility of both the salts, means this upper equilibrium and lower equilibrium both will be shifted to left hand side, because this extra concentration of carbonate ion has to be consumed fast, and in order to do so, this both the equilibriums must shift to LHS, and in that case we calculate the value of simultaneous solubility for both of these salts. Let's understand this concept with an example, right? So let me refer a statement and we will try to solve it. Question states that calculate simultaneous solubility of calcium fluoride and magnesium fluoride in same solution. This is understood. Given Ksp for magnesium fluoride is 7.3 into 10 raised to power minus 9, and Ksp for calcium fluoride is 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 10. Let's see how do we proceed. First, I consider MgF2 that ionizes to Mg and fluoride ions. Let its solubility is A and this is 2A. Calcium fluoride 2 ionizes in the same solution, giving calcium and fluoride ions. Let it be B and this is 2B. Now what we observe, that these two ions are common. Fluoride ions are common in them. So this concentration and this concentration are going to add up. So let's modify. This will become twice of A plus 2B, and this will also be changing to twice of A plus 2B. Make the two equations, like its Ksp first. So what I say, Ksp of MgF2 is equal to A into 2A plus 2B whole square. Similarly, Ksp of calcium fluoride is equal to B into twice of whole square of 2A plus 2B square. These are two equations we have prepared. Now, if we divide the two equations, so this factor will be cancelled. So can I say it will be left as Ksp of MgF2 divided by Ksp of CaF2 is equal to A by B. Let it be equation 1, let it be equation 2, and what we are doing, equation 1 divided by equation 2. You can place the values like MgF2, Ksp, it is 7.3 into 10 raised to power minus 9. This one is 1.7 into 10 raised to power minus 10 is equal to A by B. Get the value of A in terms of B and get the value of B in terms of A. Then finally, jo bhi values aapko mile, first if you obtain A, A is equal to 7.3 into 10 raised to power minus 9 divided by 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 10 B. So this value of A we obtain in terms of B. Place this value over here and then solve it. Similarly, if you obtain the value of B in terms of A, place it here in the second equation and then solve it. In that way, while we get the values of A and B, then respectively what you are getting the simultaneous solubility of both the salts, of the calcium fluoride as well as magnesium fluoride. Another concept which is important in this solubility product is known as selective precipitation. There are so many small concepts on which always there are questions in the various competitive exams. तो बच्चों आज मैं आपको इनकी फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट सिखा रही हूँ कि बेसिकली ये कॉन्सेप्ट्स है क्या और कैसे आप इनको न्यूमेरिकल्स या क्वेश्चंस में इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं। सो वी आर टेकिंग सिलेक्टिव प्रेसिपिटेशन। चलिए इसे भी एक एग्जांपल से समझेंगे। एग्जांपल लेते हैं कि हमें दो सॉल्ट्स दे दिए गए, कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड एंड मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड। दोनों के केएसपी गिवन है, दैट इज 6.5 × 10⁻⁶। सिमिलरली केएसपी ऑफ मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इज आल्सो गिवन, 7.1 × 10⁻¹². एंड बोथ ऑफ दीज can precipitize because they are sparingly soluble. They say let a solution contains 0.1 molar concentration of magnesium ion and calcium ions both. मान लीजिए एक solution में दोनों ions हैं, कैल्शियम भी मैग्नीशियम भी, और दोनों का कंसेंट्रेशन है 0.1 मोलर ईच। एंड वी ऐड सम इलेक्ट्रोलाइट प्रोवाइडिंग हाइड्रोक्साइड आयंस इन सॉल्यूशन। That can be even sodium hydroxide, it can be potassium hydroxide, lithium hydroxide or something else like that. So the question states that which will precipitize first, which will precipitize first and what shall be hydroxide ion concentration required for its precipitation. अब यहां जो कॉन्सेप्ट इन्वॉल्व हो रहा है, सबसे पहले तो उसके बारे में समझेंगे। दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेशन। कब एक सॉल्ट प्रेसिपिटाइज हो सकता है और कब वो प्रेसिपिटाइज नहीं हो सकता, तो वाइल डूइंग दिस प्रॉब्लम we need to know it first ki when can a salt be precipitized or when can it not be precipitized. So we should definitely understand the concept of precipitation first, then only we can move to this question or this problem. So I'll try to explain you concept of precipitation. बच्चों जैसे हम chemical equilibrium में दो चीजों के बारे में पढ़ के आए हैं, एक है QC. What is QC? QC को आप कहते थे रिएक्शन कोशेंट, और साइमल्टेनियसली हमने देखा कि उसी का एक इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट बनता है जिसे आप KC कहते हैं। तो QC और KC का एक रिलेशन मैंने आपको एक्सप्लेन किया था, इफ यू रिमेंबर। क्या था वो रिलेशन? कि फर्स्ट व्हेन QC इज इक्वल टू KC देन वी से रिएक्शन इज एट इक्विलिब्रियम। रिएक्शन इज एट इक्विलिब्रियम मीन्स जब एक रिएक्शन इक्विलिब्रियम में होती है, आप कहते हैं कि उसी QC की वैल्यू को हम KC कहना शुरू कर देते हैं। सिमिलरली जब आप स्पेरिंगली सोल्यूबल सॉल्ट्स के बारे में पढ़ते हैं तो हम यहां दो टर्म्स यूज करते हैं, द फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड IP एंड सेकेंड वन इज कॉल्ड KSP. IP इज डिफाइंड एज आयोनिक प्रोडक्ट and KSP as you know very well that is called solubility product. अब ionic product और solubility product वैसे तो दोनों same ही है, लेकिन जब वो state equilibrium की आ जाए तब आप IP को KSP कह सकते हैं, जैसे हम QC को KC कह सकते हैं। और अगर equilibrium से पहले की state है तब आप IP को QC consider कर सकते हैं, and we can say that equilibrium has not been established yet. So let me try to establish what is happening here. जब IP और KSP किसी salt के लिए equal हो जाएं, आप कहते हैं state of equilibrium है. State of equilibrium का मतलब यहाँ ये है कि the salt solution is just saturated. Salt solution is just saturated. Saturated का मतलब ये होता है कि the optimum quantity of solute has been dissolved into the solvent. At that particular given temperature, because this is fundamentally a temperature dependent term, and no precipitation, कोई precipitate form नहीं होगा, because whatever the optimum quantity of solute could have been dissolved into the solvent, we have already dissolved. Second state comes when you say that QC is less than KC. It means आप कहते हैं कि रिएक्शन इज स्टिल गोइंग इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. नाउ वी जस्ट कंपेयर इट ऑन द सेम बेसिस ऑफ दैट आईपी इज लेसर देन केएसपी. आईपी इज लेसर देन केएसपी. तो बेटे आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे कि अभी तक इक्विलिब्रियम का स्टेट नहीं आया है क्योंकि अभी आयनिक प्रोडक्ट सॉल्युबिलिटी प्रोडक्ट से कम है. तो आप ये कह सकते हैं दैट सॉल्यूशन इज Still unsaturated means it may require some more quantity of salt to be dissolved. Solution is still unsaturated and no precipitate will form. अभी भी कोई precipitate नहीं form होगा. And the third state comes when you say QC has gone more than KC. It means आप कहते हैं reaction is moving in the backward direction. तो आप कह सकते हैं कि when IP आयनिक प्रोडक्ट इज ग्रेटर देन KSP सॉल्युबिलिटी प्रोडक्ट, यू से सॉल्यूशन इज सुपर सैचुरेटेड. सॉल्यूशन अब सुपर सैचुरेट हो गया है मींस उसमें जो एक्स्ट्रा क्वांटिटी सॉल्यूट की डाली गई थी दैट विल फॉर्म प्रेसिपिटेट. सो दैट विल फॉर्म पीपीटी एंड प्रेसिपिटेशन विल टेक प्लेस. So this is the very very important concept you should remember कि किसी भी salt के precipitation की सबसे important concept ये है कि उसका ionic product उसके solubility product को exceed कर जाए, उससे बढ़ जाए, या ये कहें कि solubility product ionic product से कम हो जाए, तब आप कह सकते हैं कि salt में precipitation हो सकता है. अब हम बात कर लेते हैं इस question की रिस्पेक्टिव क्वेश्चन की. आई होप कि अब ये प्रेसिपिटेशन का कॉन्सेप्ट आपको समझ आ गया है कि उसके लिए हमें क्या चेक करना होता है कि भाई प्रेसिपिटेट फॉर्म होगा या नहीं होगा. अब मान लेते हैं इस समय कि इन दोनों सॉल्ट्स के लिए जो केएसपी गिवन है वो आईपी के बराबर है. आईपी एंड केएसपी आर इक्वल. तो जब आप इसे कंपेयर करें तो फर्दर फर्स्ट लेट आई कंसीडर कि फॉर मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. तो आई कैन से दिस इज द Ab2 टाइप ऑफ सॉल्ट. सो सॉल्युबिलिटी बच्चों कैसे निकाली जा सकती है, दैट कैन बी टेकन एज केएसपी बाय 4 एंड यू हैव टू टेक इट्स थर्ड रूट क्यूब रूट. ठीक है, लेट वी सॉल्व इट एंड वी ऑब्टेन द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. रादर वी डोंट नीड सॉल्युबिलिटी, वी नीड द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोक्साइड आयन. Because they ask you कि how much hydroxide ion shall be present over there so that it can precipitate. So let me consider magnesium hydroxide will ionize to get Mg+2 into plus twice of OH negative. KSP is given 7.1 into 10 to the power minus 12, that is equal to magnesium ion concentration 0.1 into hydroxide ion concentration. Suppose I consider this is going to be any value, that is x. Let the hydroxide concentration is x and I need to take x square. If it is taken concentration x, so the value of x comes to be square root of 7.1 into 10 to the power minus 12 divided by 0.1. This is in fact the hydroxide ion concentration. And this value comes for magnesium hydroxide. It is 8.4. The concentration comes to be 8.4 into 10 to the power minus 6. It states that up to this concentration of hydroxide, the magnesium hydroxide will not precipitate. because we have considered it just saturated solution because Ip has become equal to Ksp. Now we will try to find out the hydroxide ion concentration required for calcium hydroxide. So on the same way I would have taken for calcium hydroxide CaOH whole twice, hydroxide ion concentration has to be square root of Ksp 6.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by calcium ion concentration, and this value let it be 8.06 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now here we have got two values. This is the first value and this is the second value. So what we generalize? We say when hydroxide ion concentration exceeds then this, जब वो 8.4 into 10 to the power minus 6 से ज्यादा होगा, थोड़ा सा भी जब बढ़ना शुरू होगा तो मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड विल स्टार्ट प्रेसिपिटाइजिंग. और वो कब तक प्रेसिपिटाइज होगा? टिल हियर, जब तक कि उसमें हाइड्रोक्साइड आयन कंसेंट्रेशन 8.06 into 10 to the power minus 3 नहीं पहुंच जाता. और जब कंसेंट्रेशन हाइड्रोक्साइड का इससे ज्यादा एक्सीड करेगा, बढ़ेगा, तब कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड प्रेसिपिटाइज हो सकता है. एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सिलेक्टिव प्रेसिपिटेशन. इस लास्ट पॉइंट को एक बार फिर समझने की कोशिश करते हैं कि ये हाइड्रोक्साइड आयन कंसेंट्रेशन हमें कहां किसके लिए मिला? मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड के लिए. और ये हमने कब लिया? ये हमने माना कि जब आईपी और केएसपी दोनों इक्वल हैं. इसका मतलब इस समय तक सॉल्यूशन जस्ट सैचुरेटेड है और अभी तक प्रेसिपिटेशन स्टार्ट नहीं हुआ है. तो प्रेसिपिटेशन कब हो सकता है? जब हाइड्रोक्साइड का कंसेंट्रेशन इस लिमिट से ज्यादा बढ़ना शुरू होगा. लेकिन वो कब तक हो सकता है? जब तक कि उसकी लिमिट कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड के हाइड्रोक्साइड आयन तक ना आ जाए. तो इन दोनों कंसेंट्रेशंस के बीच ये लगातार मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड प्रेसिपिटाइज होता जाएगा. लेकिन जब हाइड्रोक्साइड का कंसेंट्रेशन इससे ज्यादा होगा तभी कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड का प्रेसिपिटेशन स्टार्ट होगा, क्योंकि अभी यहां तक कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड जस्ट सैचुरेटेड स्टेट में है और अभी तक हमने उसका कोई प्रेसिपिटेशन ऑब्जर्व नहीं किया है. दिस इज व्हाट वी कंसीडर सिलेक्टिव प्रेसिपिटेशन. चलिए एक लास्ट कॉन्सेप्ट और है जिसे हम देख लेते हैं, और वो कॉन्सेप्ट तब आती है जब सॉल्यूशंस में कभी कभी कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन हो जाता है. जानते हैं आप इसके बारे में कि कॉम्प्लेक्स किसे कहते हैं? सो वी कंसीडर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन. देखते हैं बच्चों कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन में क्या क्या हो सकता है. सपोज आप ये कहना चाहते हैं कि मेरे पास एक सॉल्यूशन AgCl का है और उसमें मैं सोडियम साइनाइड एड कर दूं. सोडियम साइनाइड, तो क्या होगा? इस रिएक्शन में प्रेसिपिटेशन होगा. किस चीज का प्रेसिपिटेट बनेगा? AgCN twice, right? And इसके साथ, because this is plus one, ये minus two, तो क्लोराइड इसकी वैलेंसी को फुलफिल करेगा. And simultaneously, सोडियम आयन्स विल आयोनाइज. सोडियम आयन्स विल आयोनाइज बिकॉज सिल्वर इज गोइंग टू मेक द precipitate with that. In this case, we can understand there are three types of equilibria. AgCl gives Ag plus and Cl minus. For this statement, we say this is Ksp of AgCl, which is active mass of Ag plus into active mass of Cl minus. Let it be equation one. Second equation is associated with the complex formation. Silver ion is making complex with cyanide. This will form Ag, CN twice, complex ion. For this we take a constant Kf. Kf is known to be constant of complex formation. And this will be taken as active mass of complex ion divided by active mass of silver ion multiplied active mass of cyanide square. And the third equation comes like this, AgCl we consider the whole concentration plus twice of cyanide we could have taken because sodium has no role to play. This will be forming AgCN twice negative plus Cl negative. You could have taken it as a whole. यहाँ हम क्लोराइड का पूरा कंसेंट्रेशन अलग से भी ले सकते थे. इसके लिए आप यहाँ एक लेंगे दैट इज के इक्विलिब्रियम, दैट इज इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट. इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट इज द कंसेंट्रेशन और एक्टिव मास ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स मल्टीप्लाइड क्लोराइड डिवाइडेड बाय सी एन नेगेटिव स्क्वेयर बिकॉज ए जी सी एल इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी वन. लेट मी ट्राई टू एस्टैब्लिश अ रिलेशन between equation 1, let it be equation 1, this is equation 2 and this is equation 3. Just observe them carefully. Can we have some relation between Ksp and Kf to secure this K equilibrium? Just observe and you will get it ki how we can say that this is being applied. So, if we consider that K equilibrium is equal to Ksp into Kf. Means what I'm saying, add equation 1 and 2 and you will get the equation 3. Let me see, agar hum equation 1 or 2 ko add kar dein, kya hum equation 3 milta hai? Dekhye, silver ions cancel ho jayenge. So this will become AgCl. This is twice of cyanide here. This is going to be Cl negative and this is ion here. अगर आप दो इक्वेशंस को ऐड कर दें तो उनके कॉन्स्टेंट्स मल्टीप्लाई हो जाते हैं. सो व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग हियर ऑन एडिंग इक्वेशंस 1 एंड 2. सो दिस इज द फाइनल थिंग व्हिच वी आर ऑब्टेनिंग. केएफ इज नोन टू बी केएफ. केएफ इज कॉल्ड कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन. कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन. जनरली इट्स वैल्यू इज वेरी हाई. आमतौर पर इसकी वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा होती है. इसका मतलब ये कहते हैं कि जितने भी आयंस प्रेजेंट हैं, ये रिएक्शन नियरली गोज टू कंप्लीशन. मीन्स हार्डली एनीथिंग इज लेफ्ट बिहाइंड बिकॉज इट्स वैल्यू इज वेरी हाई. बट यू नो इन केमिस्ट्री वी डोंट निग्लेक्ट इवन अ पार्शियल 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 वैल्यू. दैट्स व्हाई से दैट अ स्टेट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बट एक्चुअली दिस रिएक्शन इज ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटेड. दैट्स व्हाई द वैल्यू ऑफ केएफ इज वेरी हाई. एंड दिस रिलेशनशिप इज जनरली एप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर दोज सॉल्यूशंस इन व्हिच सम कॉम्प्लेक्स इज बीइंग फॉर्मड. So this is all with respect to all the concepts of chemical and ionic equilibrium. I hope you understood all these concepts very well. Actually इस chapter में theory कम and questions ज्यादा हैं. But the conceptual questions which are being asked in the different competitive exams, they may at least sometimes give you a good twist. क्योंकि theory पे भी concentrate करना उतना ही जरूरी है जितना कि आप उनके numericals पे करते हैं. So my suggestion is कि यू शुड ट्राई एज मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स एज यू कैन. दे कैन बी सब्जेक्टिव फर्स्ट टू हैव अ ग्रिप ओवर द टॉपिक. मतलब सब्जेक्ट में टॉपिक को समझने के लिए सबसे पहले आपको सब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस ही करने चाहिए, फिर उसके बाद आप ऑब्जेक्टिव पे शिफ्ट कर सकते हैं. सो अगर इस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड जैसे कोई डाउट्स आते हैं या कोई क्वेश्चंस आते हैं तो आप हमारी इसमें अपनी क्वेरीज डाल सकते हैं, आप अपने क्वेश्चंस भेज सकते हैं. यू कैन गिव योर कमेंट्स आल्सो. सो दैट इज अप टू यू कि आप कितनी अच्छी तरह इस चैप्टर को प्रिपेयर करें क्योंकि इसका काफी वेटेज होता है विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अवर जेई एंड नीट बोथ द प्रिपरेशंस. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट्स वेरी वेल एंड यू विल ट्राई टू यूटिलाइज देम एज मैक्सिमम एज पॉसिबल.